Well, I kind of want to try this vein out for a few seconds by sharpening the Super XL's chain as a test. And I already got those teeth already sharpened on this side. Now I'm doing it on this side. So I want to make sure that I got my gap set. Turn it on. Now, this is definitely going to be real hard to do, but I don't have it installed on it, but I got it on the piece of wood to hold it. You don't have to go crazy, but it's kind of dangerous, but you have to watch what you're doing. You hold this vein down, that locks it in place. Go real slow on it. Let it do its job. And always check before you continue to sharpen it. I need to sharpen one more time. Now it's sharp. You don't have to turn it off, you could just leave it running. Or you can move your chain to another tee if that needs to be sharp. And I already got the left side all sharpened earlier, now I'm doing it on the right side. Now that's sharp. Now you can move it to another dull teeth. I think it's gonna be hard for me to do it with one hand. So I'm gonna have to use two hands. I'm very sorry, folks. I'm gonna sit y'all down where you can watch. Where you can watch me. It's a way a lot better than using the drill and the grinder. It's way a lot better. Now that's sharp. You want this one? Oh, I already got that one sharp. I don't know how many teeth that's sharp. There might be three more that needs to be sharp. See? Now it's sharp. Sharp. We'll move on to the last one, and we'll check to make sure how many are sharp. Thank you. Yeah. Keep it sharp, and you try to do the last one. Now we got our sharp 16-inch channel. Now we can reinstall it onto the chainsaw. Now we can just put on our nuts and snug them on with our fingers, with our fingers. And we're going to turn this up. It's kind of fun to run some outside. It's really funky. There's a lot of bumping, a lot of them sounded just like a Texas Chainsaw Massacre film chainsaw. Like in horror movies and stuff. It's a lot of fun. Because it reminds me of the one that was used in Leatherface movie. And it was a Homelight 600 Doom, which the Homelight Super XL was not used in the movie. And he kind of reminds me of the Homelight XL12. Some reason that point I'm not going to restore the other one in the original condition. I just like it as the original paint that's on it. That's give us a lot of history on it, since it was century that old. But my dad used a lot of Homelight chainsaw before. But he did use it one time several years ago when he just never quit using it because they're slow. Because they're not a fast saw like the modern saws. But it was kind of in some good shape back in the day. He used it a lot. And he just definitely sold it to a friend of his a long time ago. But I've got the big lid, it looks just like his, but it's got a big red 20-inch bulb that it's sold. Alright, all the teeth on this thing is sharp. I'm going to be ready to go cut some wood again. But I'll try again in a 20-inch shootout with two Super XLs and a Husqvarna 455 wrenches. Let's see if she finds it. Okay, you turn it to the on position, you pull out the choke, and you don't need to use the throw lock because it starts real fine without the throw lock. Or you could just do it by pushing it in when it's cold and you give it a pull. And turn it this way so you can see. Sharpen the chain with the electric chain sharpener for your modern and your antique chainsaws. Now this thing runs very good. After that's hot, one pull. I hope this video will help you out. And the big red will always start. Better than the XL 12.
there's a cover on this, like a white Walmart logo, and the 85 with the red Walmart logo. But they are the same covers, but they're from different years. This thing always fires up in one tail, just like the other one.
Well, there it is, the Harbor Freight electric chain sharpener. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and don't miss out for more videos. See you later.